Na and warm Pacific greetings and welcome back to our Pacifica Health Talanoa for today, and we will continue. Talofa malolele, kia ora na whakalofalai atu, warm Pacific greetings and welcome again to another Pacifica Health Talanoa with you this week. My name is Mafi Funaki Tahifote from the Heart Foundation's Pacific Heartbeat team. And it's always great to have in the house Balangi Sul.
Warm Pacific greetings to all our listeners and our viewers, and always lovely to be here, Muffy. Thank you.
It's great. We have been having talanoa around what is healthy eating. We've talked about four food groups, and the last program we talked about lunch and how much should we have when we are talking about having lunch, well as how much should we have for afternoon tea if you're still hungry before dinner?
That's right. And I know, Muffy, you had a couple of just key points that about those lunches and those snacks that might be good to just share with the listeners and the viewers again this week.
Yes, so important, of course, was how much we were having in terms of meals. And snacks, that snacks are small, but it's to remember that for us to have lunch.
To remember to have it.
To have lunch, and it could be leftover from the previous day's dinner.
That's a good idea.
So that we don't actually feel too hungry by dinner time, and all the good, wise choices go out the window.
And the snack is, I just brought a couple of snacks with us here, that they're actually small and healthy, because they're just to get us through to the next meal, really. So it's be like a yogurt and maybe a mandarin or a nice apple and a small palm full of nuts. Yes, that just fits into the palm. And so Palangi Sue was wondering, Muffy, so if we were talking about lunches and snacks last week, the last couple of weeks, what could possibly be we be talking about this week? I just couldn't imagine.
And you couldn't guess, it would be dinner. Would be dinner and ahikingaua or dessert in the evening. So it would be great to actually move on this week to have a conversation at Talanoa around how much should our dinner look like, and how much, if we are having dessert or hikingaua, how much should that look like for our family. So dinner, how much should we have, Balangi Sue, when we are talking about having dinner,
having our dinners? Well, I've got this lovely cardboard plate here, which I got from the Diabetes New Zealand, and I think they cost about $1.50, Muffy, but it's got a picture of the portions on a dinner plate, very, very colourful, and half of the plate is actually those colourful vegetables, so that's not the starchy ones, that's those good colours, and we've got quite a few there, Muffy, haven't we?
Yeah, capsicum, celery, beans, red onions, cucumber, tomatoes, carrots, broccoli, lettuce, taro leaves, kapisi or cabbages there. We would include silver beets. So there's lots of choices in terms of colourful vegetables, and I think we are quite lucky in New Zealand that we've got access or availability of a lot of those colourful vegetables or colour of the rainbows.
And it's a really great idea to try and fill our plates with half a plate full of colourful vegetables, especially those ones that are in season, so they're cheaper. You know, it's like the cabbage at the moment and the carrots and things like that. You know, they don't cost a lot. And because they fill us up, they're full of that stuff called fibre or roughage, so they keep us full. And they also don't have hardly any energy or calories in the muffy, so they don't put on the muffin top.
So I
don't
eat to the as much as I like of those, and it won't put on weight at all.
It won't put on weight at all, and fills you up. So really awesome tip. And but I know a lot of our families, they don't, they wouldn't put like half a plate of veggies, you know, so it looks like that. They'd mix it up with the meat and the carbs, wouldn't they?
Yeah, and they'll mix it up with the meat. So they'll mix these with the meat. And I'm pointing to your plate there, Sue, in terms of adding chicken. It could be a chicken chop suey. It could be a
fried
a
rice.
Soup, yeah, fried rice. Or a soup or a soup or casserole or stew where you're mixing up. But as long as you're looking into the pot or the dish or your plate, that it's more colourful vegetables and not a lot more of the chicken.
So you can see all those colours popping out at you rather than the white of the starchy vegetables and or the meat. So it's more of those colourful vegetables. Yeah. But I know that in the last couple of weeks we talked about having a handy tool on us all day, every day, that can really help with our portions. So what handy tool have you got for our half a plate veggie, colourful veggies, Muffy?
Thank you, Valangi Sue. So if I'm putting out my big
tong and hands,
it's cupping my two hands together, and I'm putting it next to Valangi Sue's plate, showing half of the plate being the colourful vegetables. So imagining that if I'd fill this two cupped hands, it will be filled up with the tomatoes, the carrots, the cucumber, the zucchini, all those colourful vegetables in the two hands. Yeah. And I think many of our Pacific families will have probably just the one hand. You need two hands.
Amp it up.
Amp it up, and just adds to the amount of what you have. But it's not going to do anything in terms of weight. It will control blood sugars. Yeah. Anything regarding health will be awesome. They're cheaper per kilo.
Yeah, they are. And so we've done half the plate. So we've got two quarters left. And in one of the quarters, we've got those starchy vegetables like the taro. We've got the potato. We've got the kumara or the green banana, or even the rice goes in there too.
Yeah.
And
or manioque or cassava goes in there, but it is a lesser part of the plate.
It is. It's smaller than the colourful vegetables. Mm. And so your handy tool, Muffy, what have you got for us for those starchy vegetables in the
It would be putting it into a fist size. So I've got my right hand into a fist against the plate here, and it will be about a quarter of the plate with the amount of taro that I would choose to have, or whether it be kape or tamu in Samoan, or they call it the giant taro. It goes to a quarter of the plate, not half the plate. I've got two fists.
So not two fists, just the one. Okay, and then we've got our last quarter left to fill up our plate, and so it's the favourite. I know the Pacific favourite left, so that's the
our meat and meat. Our seafood. So it's the fish, shellfish that we have, chicken, pork, buaka, lamb, mutton flaps, buluma sima, of course, take the fat off. So it's trimming the fat. So these are talking about lean. And it's only having a quarter of the plate that we're looking at. But there's also another handy tool. And that's putting out my hand. I've got my right hand out. So great if you're having fish, you can have a lot more, because it's my whole hand, whole palm.
Mm-hmm. And it's just one whole hand?
One whole hand. I'm not putting two
sneaking that other one in.
And also, if it's talking about chicken and our red meat, it will be the alfinima, or the palm of your hand. And that's all the amount of goodness from that group that our body needs.
Yeah, so we've got half the plate colourful veggies, a quarter of those starchy veggies and the green banana and the rice, and we've got a quarter for the meat and the fish. Awesome, Muffy. And I know that meat costs a lot, doesn't it? And I know it's the Pacific favourite. Pacific families absolutely love it, and fish, but it can be up to about $18 a kilo, and or even more, isn't it, in the case of fish. And I also know that the Ministry of Health now suggests that adults should have no more than about half a kilogram of cooked meat a week.
A week.
I know, not
it's
a day,
half a
Muffy.
Kilo.
A week. Scary.
No, one meal. Scary in terms of amounts.
So just keeping that in mind, that it's costly and it's probably not the best for us to have too much. So have you got some tips of what families could do to maybe reduce the amount of meat they're having in their meals but still be yummy and cost less?
Firstly, if you're looking at Monday to Sunday in a week, maybe choosing a few days, 2 days a week that you don't have meat, you can swap it for fish. Or just swapping it for a dish that doesn't use meat or seafood in there. Mm-hmm. So that's a way of reducing how much you have in terms of meat. So I could choose to have fish with...
So it wouldn't be like, because fish is so expensive, but could we use tinned fish?
Tinned fish in there, but I think some of the families, if you have people who give you fish and they're fishing, that could be...
good fishermen.
Yeah, good to have in there. But fish could be tinned fish, and choosing tinned fish that's not in oil, it will be a better choice. Just having a day or two or even more in a week where you go meat free.
So it could be a fish pie with some mashed potato on the top and some frozen veggies in with the tinned
on
fish.
Top. So that will be something new to do, a fish pie. We have Pacific buying pies, but it could be a fish pie. It could be a metika paika, which is lots of colourful vegetables as a salad, and you add the a tinned fish in there. There are other ideas that you can, a pizza with other, putting a bit of, rather than chicken on top, you can put a few...
fish on there. And I know eggs are cheaper than meat as well. So I know Mum used to make a quiche. What were you called? A quiche or an egg pie or
a layered dish.
So just with, I've got half a dozen eggs here, and you just whip them up with a bit of milk and put some veggies in, some in-season veggies, or some frozen veggies. Even can add. Yeah, just even a tiny bit of chicken, but some cheese on the top, and whack it in the oven.
Yeah.
So
it could be leftover rice, and you whack up some eggs and make an omelette, chop it up and put it in as a egg fried rice.
Yeah, so a couple of meatless options. Days. That would definitely save on the pocket, wouldn't it? And reduce the amount of meat.
Definitely.
And have you got another tip there, Muffy?
Yeah, there's a couple more balangisu. It could be that rather than actually some days of the week being meat-free or free of meat, it could be that they reduce the amount of meat that they'll use in a dish and add up, replace it with some legumes. For example, if you're making spaghetti bolognese, reduce the amount of mince, and then you can add it up with some red beans. And we've got some red beans in front of here, and they come in the
chili
cans.
Beans, isn't it?
Yep, and chili beans if you want to spice it up. Of course, adding chickpeas as well in it. So,
and that's lovely in a lamb curry. I know. I've done that before.
So really nice. So if it's a pizza, rather than actual meat, you can put the red beans on top with pizza. So just stews as well.
Yes.
If less meat in a stew or soup or a casserole, you can add some of those chickpeas or legumes in there.
And
or
I
even
know,
leftover baked beans.
Actually, baked beans is good baked
beans.
But I use the lentils. Actually, I use these ones, the King's Soup Mix, which are lentils, and this is the vegetable one, which is low in salt as well. So it's good for people with high blood pressure, and you can get them quite cheaply at the Pack and Save to bulk up the soup.
To bulk up,
instead of meat. Yeah. You don't actually need the meat.
No, and if you reduce meat as well, rather than all these beans and so forth, you can also add some of the vegetables, colourful vegetables, like the frozen mixed vegetables, or just fresh carrots, broccoli, whatever you've got in season at the time, or
that's
even
a good tip.
Adding in canned tomatoes.
Canned tomatoes. They're often cheap. You can get them
on special. 90 cents or under a dollar, definitely, for some of the cheaper brands, but they will be cheaper than the fresh tomatoes, unless of course they're in season.
And what about like the kids? Kids often don't like vegetables, Muffy, so if you've got some tips for palangisu to share with the listeners about getting more veggies.
I know that they don't want it in bulk or larger amounts when they're chewing on them. So grating them, just getting carrots and grating them, or if in season, zucchini and cucumber, you can grate it so that they don't really taste that volume in their mouth.
They can't see it. You're hiding it. Yeah, that's a great one. And what about some cheap places to get some? Get vegetables, because we often hear in our training that people say, oh, but vegetables are too expensive, that's why I don't have so many. But there are some cheaper places to get vegetables, aren't there, Muffy?
There are cheaper places, but I think if you're looking at how much per kilo food costs, then you're mentioning $18. It could be for meat, $18 a kilo, as opposed to carrots could be a few dollars a kilo. So there's a huge difference when you're looking at price per kilo. But there are cheaper places. For example, I know here in Auckland, and there may be for outside of Auckland, the markets will be cheaper. There are fruit and veggie shops.
They're popping up everywhere now, aren't
they?
Yeah,
fruit and veggie shop will be cheaper. And just watching out for specials when they've got it in bigger supermarkets.
Yes.
But then again, you can also grow your own vegetables.
Yeah, I've got a gardener in the family. That's
so,
a great idea.
Yeah, so there are cheaper places, and markets is one of them.
Yeah. And those frozen ones, like we said, if they're on special and you've got a freezer or a big freezer box, great to throw them in there. And then you've always got them. You don't have to think about it. Yeah.
Yeah. And I know we are coming out to the end of our Pacifica Health Talanoa.
It goes
really quick. But just mentioning quickly around dessert.
Oh, yes.
Dessert. Yeah, that if we are not having ice cream, we can just get a pottle of 1 kilogram of yogurt and fresh fruit into it. So we've got fresh fruit, a banana or an apple, chop it in, pears, kiwi fruit, whatever you've got in season.
And if we haven't got fresh fruit,
then you can actually buy canned
just
ones.
Just some canned fruit.
And
just
in juice would be a better choice for them.
Or drain it out too, hey.
But you don't necessarily have to have ikingau or a dessert. But if you want something sweet, that's a better option than ice cream with fruit. But apart from that, it's the Pacifica Health Talanoa for this week.
Gosh, it goes quickly.
But we do encourage, if you do have any questions, do put it through Facebook, Pacific Heartbeat NZ, or otherwise just give us a call and we will try and answer your questions in the next Pacifica Health Talanoa. Apart from that,
should we mention what we're going to do next time, do you reckon, Muffy, just quickly?
In the next one, I think it will be great that we've done all of the amounts.
Yeah, and the meals.
Let's start to plan.
Yeah, let's do a plan, because we've been talking about all these meals, and maybe it will be a good idea to plan some meals for the families. Might save some money, save some stress. Yeah.
Yeah. So that brings us to the end of the program, and until next time, we do send our love and our ofatu to all Tongans who have lost their Prime Minister. May his soul rest in peace. Tua ofa e ki atu.
Pacifica Health Talanoa, proudly brought to you by Pacific Heartbeat at the Heart Foundation.
Malo la Maria hu eiki, lele e tonga pe mwivulangi katoa pe.